And welcome back to more Let's Play Mass Effect 2. Woo. I'm the RPG Chick. Just, guys, let me know, if you can, in the comments, how the video looks during this video, and the sound and everything, if it's the same as before, better, worse, or the same. Because we've had a massive update to GeForce Experience. I use Shadowplay. They changed it to the name of Share, which is stupid. S-H-A-R-E, not Share, the singer. So, I'm a little concerned. I mean, everything looks the same to me. I'm just a little concerned that they might have changed so much with it. But it looks like the same basic functionality. They just added some stuff and more, like, more broadcasting features and more, you know, sharing straight to Google, straight to YouTube, I don't know, things that I don't do, so I'm not really paying attention to that. I'm just concerned that the quality is the same and everything else works the same. I had to reconfigure the thing. Do I need fuel? I had to reconfigure the thing to, you know, how my mic works, you know, not push to talk, and my save file location, and yes, I want 1080p, so I'm just worried that it's not working the same, but anyone with a sharp eye and or ear, you know, let me know how it's looking. So, we're about to proceed with the main quest, which is very exciting, but first I want to finish exploring the Krogan DMZ cluster, I guess it is. So we're gonna look at Dranic, or Dranic. We might have a mission or something to run into here, I don't know. What the hell is this? Are these all little moons? Rothla. Once Rothla was a large ice dwarf with the statistics listed below. In the waning years of the Krogan rebellions, it was shattered into a field of debris by what is assumed to have been the test of an exotic weapon system. In the wake of the event, the planetoid was reduced to a relatively contained field of thousands of tiny moonlets rotating around one another, colliding and ricocheting. The method used to destroy the planetoid has never been deduced. The Krogan clan who performed the experiment apparently all died in the event. Ships that have traveled to the edge of the event's light cone observed a moment of extreme gravitational lensing around Rothla immediately before its breakup, but no other clues. A popular extranet meme put forth by Asari author Delce Orthiza insists that the Turians are covering up the existence of a Krogan superbiotic breed that was genetically engineered within Rothla. The CDEM enforces quarantine around the Rothla field, citing cases of amateur investigators whose ships came to grief in the debris field. It's freaking cold down there. Alright, I'm not picking up anything. What do we need? We only need... We still don't need anything. But I'm only gonna pick up the element zero if we find it. Well, there's a little bit there, I think. A tiny bit? Let's see if we can... Oh, yeah. We'll increase it. It's pretty rare to find, you know.
Launching probe.
I kind of don't want to scan planets if there's nothing to find, you know, and I kind of want to keep scanning planets. So there you go. We'll be done with it shortly. We'll be fighting for our lives soon. I'm gonna take this one.
Launching probe.
See how high we can get that. That Ezo going here.
Probe launched.
So yeah, if I don't find anything else here, I'm just gonna head right for the Reaper IFF mission system. I don't think I've even looked at the planets in that system too, so it's very likely we'll, you know, be
probe away,
doing something else this episode than heading for the IFF. All depends. I mean, you never find more than one planet per system that has some a quest to do. But we might find some here in the DMZ cluster.
Probe away. Probe away.
It's a really good plan to look. And I don't know if it's just the way I was looking before, but in the beginning of the game I was hardly finding any Ezo. It seems like I'm finding a lot now. Like almost every system I've been going to has a planet with some, you know, bunch like this. Checking. Check the poles area. I keep running out of mouse pad here. The other weird thing is that, I don't know why, this new NVIDIA software reduced my mic volume. Good thing I caught that. You guys have been struggling to hear me. Yeah, I did a couple test runs. Another tiny planet here. Sazgoth. Sounds like a something from out of H.P. Lovecraft. Sazgoth is a small ice dwarf with an eccentric orbit. During perigee, portions of its icy surface sublimate into a thin atmosphere of nitrogen and carbon dioxide, which quickly freeze again as it recedes into the outer reaches of the Dranic system. We are rich in resources. Resources that I do not require, so... game just keeps telling me. Wish I had an option to just dismiss that forever. Nope, don't think we're gonna find any Ezo here. Not desperate for finding it either, that's for sure. Alright, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4 planets. This is the second from the sun. Door. Door is a conventional methane ammonia ice giant. It is the main fueling port in the Dranic Cluster Gateway System. Pildia Station, the headquarters for patrol ships of the Council Demilitarization Enforcement Mission, CDEM, lies at the trailing Lagrange point of Door. The CDEM logs all ships passing through the Krogan Demilitarized Zone and has the right to board and search them for contraband at any time and for any reason. There are no exceptions. At points over the last 2 centuries, diplomatic incidents have been caused when the patrol frigates boarded an Asari hospital ship, a Batarian diplomatic courier, and privately owned human tramp freighters. Okay, this is when you guys in the comments will tell me what a tramp freighter is. Are they like prostitutes on board or something? Tramp freighter. That would beat out the Mile High Club, wouldn't it? Be like, yeah, 400 light years away club. These measures are provided for under the terms of the Krogan Armistice. While the Krogan were allowed to retain their government and personal weapons, any attempt to provide starship-mounted weapons to the clans on Tuchanka is punishable by law. Nearly a millennia after the war ended, the official penalty for smuggling prescribed weapons is still death by spacing. Wow. Population 7,300. CDEM garrison is 1,100, not including patrol ship crews. We are moderate here. Just going to do a quick pass. Thank you. thing to get. Not for us, anyway. And finally, first planet. Kellum. Kellum is a tectonically inert rock with an atmosphere of krypton, xenon, and argon. There are a few valuable loads of light metal scattered across its surface, but these are difficult to find. Most were mined out in the years leading up to the Krogan rebellions. Moderate. Not finding stuff. Huge amount there of iridium and some palladium. We do not need. Alright. Done with Dranic. Or Dranic. Let's go fuel up first. Hey. Okay, heading for the last system. There's actually probably not a lot of planets in here because we're already 76% done. Well, apparently we got three. Oh, wow. You're burning up, man! We got these planets. Where's the other one? Okay, so we've got two tiny planets and looks like a gas giant here. Vard. Vard is a methane ammonia ice giant. Until the Krogan rebellions, it had a sizable helium-3 fuel refining infrastructure. Once the solar arrays orbiting Nith were destroyed, the constant flow of anti-proton tankers visiting the system disappeared. There was little point to maintaining the facilities, so they were shut down and abandoned. Today, the ancient stations are squatted by transients, criminals, and outcasts. Although few are safe for habitation, neither the Krogan nor the Council Demilitarization Enforcement Mission patrols care if they take their chances. Population is 2,072. We have moderate results. I mean, I don't even know if we're covering the whole surface with what I'm looking at, but it's just very quick. We do not really need this stuff. We have so much. Good enough. Let's check out this tiny one. Tula. Tula's methane ammonia atmosphere traps the blistering heat of Nith, driving dayside temperatures up over 1,000 degrees. While some loads of useful metals are present, the planet's incredible heat makes mining impractical. You know what, actually, I have to stop by the Shadowbroker base one more time. So I think that's going to make up this episode. Sorry, guys. Main stuff next episode. Of course, we still have one more planet to check out here. See if there's anything going on. Distress signal or random stuff going on. Manton. The Class B Blue Giant Nith was once the most strategically valuable system within Krogan territory. Though far too hot for habitable planets, Nith emits thousands of times the energy of a main sequence star like Earth's Sol. With help from Solarian uplift teams, the Krogan constructed a chain of solar power collector stations in orbit around Nith. These vast arrays beamed power to particle accelerators on the surface of Manton, which manufactured anti-proton fuel for warship thrusters. In the Krogan rebellions, the Spectre agents managed to get a virus onto the computers of the solar power arrays. Every fifth array suddenly applied braking thrusters. The arrays behind them piled up and all were reduced to wreckage. This has since dispersed into a relatively stable ring system. The Krogan never had the resources to rebuild the solar arrays, depriving them of their fleet's main fuel supply for the remainder of the war. The particle accelerators still exist on Manton, but have not been used in thousands of years. Alright, yeah, nothing going on here on these planets. Except for some Element Zero.
Launching probe.
See, I've been finding it on every system. I mean, maybe it's since we upgraded our sensors that we can find more ESO where we couldn't detect it before.
Launching probe.
Or the game is otherwise set up to give you a deficit of ESO in the beginning.
Probe away.
If so, then it definitely worked, because often I didn't have enough for my upgrades. Now, I mean, I'll never use all this. Check one more time in here. Nope, we're good. Over 115k. And we are completely done. This nebula. And back for the fueling station and the mass relay. Wait. Probes. Just in case. Okay, we're going into Shadow Broker Base. If I can see it, thank you. Oh. Forgot it's not in the landing system. So Willow. See if we got any new files and stuff on our members. New videos, investments to do, that kind of thing. Hello there. Was there something falling? She's not gonna say anything, unfortunately.
Thanks for coming by.
Well, thanks, baby. Let's check my investment opportunities. Mission report ready for the embedded correspondence. Okay. Success. Citadel journalists are now reporting live from the Terminus systems. 4,000 credits. Blue listed. Mission report ready. I like barely remember this stuff. Failure. The Blue Suns whip up an advertising campaign to counter your bad press. Mercs? My god. Advertising campaigns? Alright, let's check out the ones we had already. Mutually assured income. Failure. Several Car Sun Car Shan stations have acquired WMD's weapons of mass destruction that tip the balance in their favor. Well, damn them. Chemical warfare. Success! Your agent warns Binary Helix about a Citadel inspection a week before it happens. Cool. Now we got Arbitrator. The garden world of Anher went through a bloody political rebellion a few years ago, and a depressed economic climate has rekindled old grudges. Set up neutral ground for peace talks to prevent the colony from slipping back into a civil war. It definitely seems worthwhile. And false prophets. A rapidly growing cult called the Followers of the Exalted Light of the Word. That's a long name. Is gaining a foothold in Omega. Send agents to infiltrate the controversial rebellion and... religion. And siphon off donation money for yourself. Sure, why not? Let's check the dossiers, although... there shouldn't be anything new. But you never know. Plus, we don't know... yeah. Just checking to see if there's anything new. And it's really just going by memory. Unfortunately, you can't see what was read or not. As what I can tell, this stuff is all... yeah. It all looks familiar to me. Hopefully I'm correct. Garrus. Samara. Tally. I don't think I've read the Tally stuff. I'm not sure we had her as part of the crew. Alright, so I'll just read through it. Suit process log. Upgraded interface GUI for Relic Technology. Fee authorization Project Haystrom. Upgraded suit diagnostics for radiation detected. Same. Upgraded Omnitool for enhanced data integrity. Same. Upgraded translator software for all human languages. Installed suit application NutriScan 2.2. Installed suit application Engine Master 3.6. Human vessels. This is like software for, could be a combination of software and hardware for her suit. Installed suit application Nerve Stim Pro. Downloaded entertainment vid Exiles, Portraits of the Lost Quarians. Installed prototype defense suite Shield Jack 0.8. Authorization Admiral Han Gerol Vasnima. Upgraded medical scanning and quarantine suite. Ran process. Infection treatment, isolated. Downloaded educational vid dealing with loss. Aww. Uninstalled suit application Nerve Stim Pro and then reinstalled it. Downloaded education vid Understanding Body Language Human Edition. Downloaded entertainment vid Fleet and Flotilla. Uninstalled suit application Nerve Stim Pro. Downloaded education vid Human Courtship and Mating. Oh my. She's getting into it. Installed suit application Immunoboost Professional Edition. Reinstalled suit application Nerve Stim Pro Deluxe Edition. Email chain to Shadow Broker from Talizora Narea. I know you don't know me. I'm the daughter of Admiral Rael Zora, and I've run into trouble on my pilgrimage. I was investigating a disabled Gath and found a recording that seems to indicate that a specter named Saren is working with the Gath. He's betrayed the Council and is working for some group called the Reapers. Well, this is old email, huh? I'm on the Citadel now, but Saren's people are after me. This is too big for me to deal with. I'm willing to offer you the information in exchange for protection. Are you interested? Okay, so this is probably before we even met Tali. To Tali, etc. from Shadowbroker. I'm interested, and you were smart to come to me. I have an enforcer on the Citadel named Fist. He can protect you. Give him the information, and let him get you someplace safe. Right from the club on the Citadel. Yeah, that didn't quite work out for her either. No deal. From Tali. No deal. Saren has turned too many people against me. If we're doing this, I want to meet you in person. I can't trust anybody else. Well, the Shadowbroker doesn't play that way. Understood. I'll meet you in person. Fist will set it up. Oh, really? That's right. She did seem to know a lot about the Shadowbroker. To Fist from Shadowbroker. I'm forwarding you the intel on a Quarian named Tali Zora. She wants a meeting, and she's got valuable intel. Get her someplace safe and avoid any intelligence channels. Spectre Saren Artarius is after her. When you get the intel, kill the Quarian and any of our operatives who had access to the data. This information cannot be compromised. Top level security. You'll be compensated for the loss of any of your people. Well, I'm really glad that Fist failed. To Shadowbroker from Tali, your agent was compromised. He tried to sell me out to Saren. I've turned the information over to a human Alliance commander named Shepard, and I think I've got all the protection I need. Aw, shucks. Thank you for your offer, and I hope this does not affect any future exchanges. To Tali from Shadowbroker. Of course, I apologize for Fist's behavior. Should you ever change your mind, I'd be more than happy to offer my personal protection. Please contact me. Contact me at your earliest convenience. Totally played her. Totally played poor Tali. Keystroke log. Omnitool use Citadel. Begin new message. Dear Sen and Hesesh Jorin, I am. Erase. To the parents of Mir Jorin, Vas. Erase line. My name is Tali Zora Vasnima, and I led the unit where your son was killed on Haystrom. Partial line erase. Led the unit on Haystrom where your son died. Partial line erase. Unit on Haystrom where Mir Jorin died. Save progress. I didn't know Mir Jorin well, but he seemed like a good soldier and a brave young... Erase line. She was very carefully. She really didn't know how to put this. I didn't get the chance to know Mir very well, but... Erase line. I only served with Mir for a short time, but I was impressed by his bravery and his commitment to his people. Save progress. He died so that I could... Erase. He saved me at the sacrifice of his... Erase. He gave his life to get data that the Admiralty Board felt was... Partial line erase. To get data that will one day bring us back to Homeworld. I don't know if that helps. Partial line erase. Back to Homeworld, and we all honor his sacrifice. Save progress. I regret. Erase line. I am sorry for your... Erase line. I understood what you must be. Erase line. Save draft and exit. She really had trouble with that. I mean, it's really bad news, a touchy subject in general. I mean, I'm not sure if she was informing them of his death, or they were already aware, and she just... Yeah. It looks like they already were informed, and she just wanted to send, you know, her respects, this and that, condolences. Anything else? Kasumi. No, this is the same. This is from, from two Pellet. Okay. scene. Yeah. That's his medical report. It'd be cool if when you, you know, do their loyalty missions. Tasty bites. They got new entries. Yeah, how many cigarettes you smoked? Could you imagine if this was real and you could really look through all these files? It'd be, like, way too much to even, like, pick things out. I mean, how many days would they actually know how many cigarettes he smoked and stuff like that? I mean, if they were able to, you know, spy on him daily, it would just go on daily. Mr. Anderson. Saren, a hero. Huh. Request denied. Heck, it's awesome. Alright, that's it.
I've got next year's code enhancements for the Alcor kinetic language processing ready for download.
Oh, this is our training. Yeah, God. Okay, so we've got a shipment of 1250 Element Zero. Cool. Thanks, cutie. Shutter control and survey information. I just get them, just to get them. Just to clear it out, you know. That's my own research? Yeah. I don't want to change my armor. Let's check back here. Videos.
I've advanced the date of the hard copy archive backups to 2 days from now.
Hi again, Shepard.
Take it easy, Baron.
Thanks.
Poor guy. I remember how he was tortured like that. See if you got any new videos.
Aria Talok, Omega.
Saying. She's apparently hanging with two Turians, and I don't know what they have on the table with them. So, gonna drink? Or microphones? Maybe she's interviewing. Maybe those are microphones? Could be drugs. Who the hell knows?
Fred Mazai, Citadel.
Shot one of them.
Donnell Udina, Citadel.
Oh, Udina. Where are you going, Udina?
Armando Bailey, Citadel.
Oh, Captain Bailey? I forgot his last name. His first name is Armando. Well, I never knew. Either way, he doesn't look like an Armando.
Thank you.
David Anderson, Citadel.
Mr. Anderson. He got him. Didn't fall him though. Hope he's okay.
Praetor Gavorn. Omega.
Well, there's a lot of people getting shot and killed, huh?
Kalisa Bint Sinan Al-Jilani. Citadel.
Hey, hey. I don't even know who those two are. Kalisa? On the Citadel?
Keeper 20, Citadel.
Huh. They're doing some kind of access shaft. I mean, I talked to several Asari on the Citadel. I just don't remember which one that is. I'm so bad with names.
Matriarch Athita. Ilium.
On Ilium. What'd she do? Headbutt him? What's that one with the arms up in the air doing? Huh.
Erdnot Torsk, Tachanka.
Oh my. That's the experiment he has going? What are you doing? It's just incinerate a human? Definitely looks like a human being. I don't know what he's up to over there. I didn't see any humans on Tachanka.
Elias Kellum, Citadel.
Dragging a Turian to safety? Or away? Dead Turian? Unconscious Turian?
Miranda Lawson and Jacob Taylor. Lazarus Research Station. Ship now defunct.
Oh my. So where's Shepard? Is she on a table somewhere? Or pieces of her? Or molecules of her? What did he say? Is that part of the intro? That doesn't sound like English. It sounds like he's talking backwards almost.
Garrus Vakarian, Omega.
Garrus. He took a shot. Oh no, he's running and guns blazing. Oh, then he took a shot.
Arya Talok, Omega.
Okay, we're back to that. Now we're
16 Quarians returning, and 5 leaving the flotilla today. 2 are embarking on pilgrimage.
Oh, goody. Don't know what I would have done without that information. So yeah, running longer than I thought. Bye, sweetie. I know you're not going to say anything to me. I can't have a meaningful conversation with you. So, I'll see you soon. And I got stuck. I have no idea why. Okay. Well, yeah. Alright, quitting out here. Next episode for sure, we're gonna head for that system with the Reaper IFF. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.